The reason behind all the contradictions in Mr. Kudo's testimony is simple. Mr. Kudo made a mistake, denke ich nicht. The ear doctor made a mistake, denke ich nicht. The victim was a phony? Muss es denn ja sein? This case is riddled with contradictions. Yet, there is one very simple answer that clears them all up.
And what is that?
The incident Mr. Kudo witnessed and the incident the victim experienced were two completely different events.
What?
Yes, the victim that Mr. Kudo saw wasn't Mr. Glenn Elg at all. It was an imposter, a phony pretending to be Mr. Elg. Obviously, unlike the victim, there was nothing wrong with the imposter's left eardrum. That's how he ended up wearing the earpiece in his left ear by mistake. Das ergibt natürlich Sinn, wenn da einfach jemand anders sich hingesetzt hat und so getan hat, als wäre er jetzt Glenn Elg. Der wusste ja nichts davon, dass Glenn Elgs linkes Ohr kaputt war und hat sich das dann einfach da stumpf reingesteckt. Soweit könnte das sein.
Order, order in the court, settle down, already clear the courtroom.
Aber wer soll denn dann da bitteschön gesessen haben?
Quiet, Gramps, why don't you clear out of here, huh?
Holy shit.
What did you say?
Tried. Are you saying that what Mr. Kudo saw was a setup?
Yes. Someone pretended to be Glenn Elg and acted out the whole coffee poisoning, all for the express purpose of creating a witness out of one Mr. Victor Kudo. Objection. Das ist schon ziemlich verrückt.
Get real, Tried. Why would anyone want to do that?
Isn't it obvious? The thing Mr. Kudo was most insistent about in his testimony was...
The serving girl brought him a Giacchino, but she put something in it. That's the serving girl right there in the defendant's chair. I remember her well.
Um es auf jemand anders zu pinnen.
It's so hard to believe, but...
There was one and only one reason to show Mr. Kudo this fake poisoning. To show Maggie Bird in the act of poisoning the coffee.
Objection. Are you insinuating that the waitress in the old man's story was a fake as well? It's true that there were no other customers in the restaurant at the time, but... It's also true that the chef was there. He would have noticed what was happening.
That's right. Well, witness, if your restaurant really was the scene of such theatrics, you would have known about it, correct?
Oh la la, this is most difficult for me.
Objection. No, it's quite simple. All you have to do is testify. You are under oath, after all. Was there, in fact, a phony at Trebien that day? The defense demands that Mr. Armstrong tell the whole truth about what happened.
The defense's request for additional testimony is accepted. You will accurately explain in detail the events in the restaurant that day.
Oui?
Okay.
La victim, Monsieur Elg, he came to my restaurant alone. I remember the old man arrived not long after him.
Okay.
There were no other customers. When he got word he won la lottery, Monsieur Elg became very excited. It was approximately 5 minutes later that la poisoning incident occurred.
Okay.
No, there was no time for a phony to do la acting.
Just so we're clear, there was no mirror in the restaurant, after all.
Je veux de ma pardon.
Was?
Forgive me, Your Honor. I lied because I wanted this mess to be cleared up quickly.
What you have just done is commit perjury, Mr. Armstrong. I will decide how to punish you later.
Sehr gut.
Oui.
For now, we will hear your cross-examination. Mr. Wright, if you please.
He took that perjury charge a bit too well. But I'm guessing he'll be in more serious trouble after this cross-examination. Das Gefühl habe ich auch.
The victim, Monsieur Elg, he came to my restaurant alone.
Was he alone at his table as well?
Mais oui, I saw him from the kitchen.
Ich weiß übrigens nicht, wie man dieses M-A-I-S, also Mais, ausspricht. Ich rate einfach nur, ich kann kein Französisch. Wenn das irgendjemand weiß und das ist falsch und man sagt nicht mehr, ich komme mir wie ein Schaf dabei vor, könnt ihr mich natürlich gerne korrigieren. Aber okay, offenbar ist mehr sogar richtig.
Mais oui, I saw him from La Kitchen.
Lerne ich ja noch Französisch hier, huh? Yet the defendant Miss Bird remembers it differently. She swears there was another man at the victim's table. Huh, unfortunately for you, Trite. Yesterday's witness also testified that the victim was alone. You know, seeing you squirm like that reminds me of a certain coffee's bittersweet bite.
What kind of coffee has he been drinking? It's not coffee, it's love. It's love that's bittersweet.
Hearing Maya say that makes her seem wise all of a sudden. It does.
I remember the old man arrived not long after him.
By old man, you mean Victor Kudo, correct?
Oui, he comes often for my special coffee.
I drank your coffee once, Mr. Armstrong. It's special, I'll give you that. It's worth a sip just for the experience.
Oh, you make me so happy, monsieur. You are most welcome anytime.
I said it was worth one sip and nothing more.
Ouch. So old Mr. Kudo arrived at the restaurant around the same time as the victim. Maybe you should ask about his arrival in more detail. Wie viel Uhr? Es wäre wichtig zu wissen, wie spät es war, weil... Das hatte ich ja vorhin schon mal... oder angemerkt, dass das mit der Zeit vielleicht noch irgendwie wichtig sein könnte. 1.30 Uhr. Ja. Ich frage jetzt mal, wie spät es war. Wie viel später danach ist jetzt... Weiß ich nicht, wie wichtig das ist. Aber es wäre erstmal wichtig zu wissen, wie spät es überhaupt war.
Out of curiosity, about what time was it when Mr. Kudo arrived?
Oh, no. I cannot remember, monsieur.
I believe we were told by a witness yesterday.
The crime was reported at 2:25.
Oh. Shit, das ist ja eine ganze Stunde fast später. Also in Bezug jetzt auf die Lotto-Show.
Crime was reported at 2:25 p.m. by a kind of scary old man, sir.
Does that perhaps jog your memory, witness?
The incident happened about 20 minutes after he arrived. So the victim must have arrived between 2 p.m. and 2:20 p.m., no?
Ja, und das kann dann aber überhaupt nicht sein.
Just after 2, huh? Thank you for your help in jogging my memory, monsieur. You are wonderful.
I can sit here all the time and do nothing now, can I?
Also du gibst gerade zu, dass du normalerweise da sitzt und die ganze Zeit gar nichts machst.
The time of day will be added to the witness's testimony.
Oui, monsieur Judge. Everything I do it for you.
Merci bien. That's French, isn't it?
I'm glad at least one person is in a good mood.
He's even humming a song to himself.
Wenigstens der hat Spaß.
I remember the old man arrived not long after him, just after 2 p.m. There were no other customers. When he got word he won la lottery, Mr. Elk became very excited.
Ja, das kann er überhaupt nicht sein. Dann kann er nämlich, hier ist ja die Uhrzeit, ich denke jetzt mal, dass ich hier präsenten muss. Ich war fast versucht, das hier zu machen. Weil es ja auch darum geht, die Lottoansage, die um 1.30 Uhr ist, aber da, das hier die Textbox mit der Uhrzeit ist, denke ich mal, dass es hier präsentieren muss. Ich weiß nicht, speichere mal lieber. Also ich denke, ich weiß die Antwort, wie ich hier weiterkomme, ich weiß nur gerade nicht genau, wo ich es am besten präsentiere. Aber, wie gesagt, wir haben ja gelernt, die Lottozahlen von dieser Lotto-Show wurden immer um 1.30 Uhr verkündet. Also passt das nicht zusammen. Dann hätte der ja schon vor 1.30 Uhr gekommen sein müssen.
I'm afraid I finally got you, Mr. Armstrong.
What do you mean?
At the time in question, the victim was listening to the radio with his earpiece. The show he was listening to was Millionaire Radio. Each week they announced the winning numbers of the $500,000 lottery ticket.
Oui, that must be the show Monsieur Elk was listening to.
I can't see any problem with this testimony, Mr. Wright.
I wonder...
You say the victim arrived at your restaurant after 2 p.m., correct?
Oui, I am sure of it. I remember it perfectly now.
Haha.
I know it was that time because I had just finished serving the lunch menu.
Get to the point, Droid, if you have one.
Oh, I do have one, because that show was broadcast live at 1:30 p.m. and it claims to be the most thrilling 10 minutes of your life.
It's on the air at 1:30.
Now, supposedly, the victim made some noise when it was announced that he had won. And yet, I don't believe his cry of joy could have occurred after 2 p.m.
Because the show had already finished more than 30 minutes earlier by that point in time.
No!
This victim we've been told about has done nothing but the impossible. Listening to the radio with a ruptured eardrum. Catching a show that was already over. There's only one conclusion you can draw from these facts. This victim was an imposter acting out the poisoning 30 minutes after the real murder.
Yes, there were two Glen Elks in Trebien that day. The real Glen Elk, now dead, having been poisoned by the real killer. And the phony Glen Elk acting out the events for Mr. Kudo to witness.
It certainly seems that way. I mean, if that wasn't the case, how could you explain the time discrepancy?
Quite a performance, Stride. You were almost on a roll. But sadly, you lack the rock-hard foundation of rhythm to build your song.
What is this? Music Theory 101?
Let's recap. According to your imaginative theory, it's now just after 2 p.m. The phony elk is performing a play for the benefit of Mr. Kudo. How do you explain then where the real Glen Elk is?
I don't believe I have to spell this out for the court, however, at that time the real Glen Elk is already dead.
That's certainly the obvious conclusion.
Objection. Thank you, Trite. That's exactly what I was hoping you would say.
What?
Now, I presume you can prove this theory of yours. Can you explain where the missing corpse went to?
The missing corpse?
According to the old man's testimony, there was only one other customer there. If that customer was the phony Glen Elk, then where did the killer hide the body of the real victim?
Ja, da gibt ja nur ein weiteres Zimmer. Das muss ja die Küche gewesen sein. Ich meine, er wird ihn ja nicht an den Tisch gesetzt haben irgendwo. Geht ja nicht. Ja. Also ich tippe jetzt mal auf die Küche. Es muss ja irgendwo da... Ich will den auch nicht draußen auf die Straße gelegt haben, denke ich mal. Und wie gesagt, es war nur ein, gibt ja nur ein anderes Zimmer, das da existierte. Ich meine, wir werden wahrscheinlich auch noch Toiletten gehabt haben, haben wir nicht gesehen, aber ja. Ich tippe mal auf die Küche.
The prosecution has a valid point, Mr. Wright. If your theory is to stand up to examination by the court, you must provide us with proof by answering the prosecution's question.
Proof? Eine Toilette war eine Küche? Oh, okay.
Where did the killer hide the body?
Yes, Your Honor.
No conjecture, Trial. Let's hear some facts for once. Show the court a piece of evidence that proves where the body was hidden.
Evidence?
What's with the intense pressure in here all of a sudden?
I thought I had him with that contradiction. But he's turned it all around and backed me into a corner instead.
Well, Mr. Wright, the court will now hear the defense theory and evidence. First, where was the body of the real Mr. L concealed?
Ich glaube nicht draußen. Ich nehme mal an, wenn das... Wenn der Mörder wirklich die Idee gehabt hat, wir machen das jetzt einfach... Dass wir mit irgendeinem... Warten, bis ein anderer Kunde kommt und dann spielen wir die ganze Vergiftung nochmal nach, damit wir das auf die Kellnerin... pinnen können, dann muss das ja recht schnell gegangen sein. Ich denke mal, die werden dann nicht irgendwie draußen versteckt für eine Leiche gesucht haben. Wäre auch etwas riskant. Ich bleibe dabei, dass es drinnen gewesen sein muss. Wahrscheinlich die Küche. Autopsie? Wir hatten eine Autopsie, ja. Died of potassium cyanide poisoning. Time of death was between 1:30 and 2:30 p.m. Ja, das, die Zeit hier, die ist natürlich ein bisschen großzügig. Da haben wir jetzt Glück mit der ganzen Lotto-Geschichte. Ich kann mal eben gucken, ob wir irgendwas haben, was das Ganze mit der Küche verbinden könnte. Das sind meine Attorney's Badge, Magatama, Sports Paper, war nicht in der Küche, Magazine Clipping, sowas Frowns, Job Listing, das Essen war in der Küche, ja, aber das wird damit nichts zu tun haben, das wollen wir auch nicht. Moment mal, wir hatten doch, Kann Könnte das irgendwie... Das Ding. The victim's ear medicine. Found covered in unidentified fingerprints in the kitchen. Aha. Ich glaube, das könnte sein. It would have been too dangerous to take the body outside. Obviously, the body must have been hidden somewhere inside Trebien.
Right. Interesting. But where could a body have been hidden inside the restaurant? Perhaps you would care to show the court on these plans, Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor. Also bisher hätte ich einfach nur die Küche geraten, aber jetzt kann ich es da sogar mit Nachdruck sagen. Und zwar ganz genau hier. Ich habe den Text gerade nicht lesen können, aber ist ja klar, worum es jetzt geht.
The body was hidden here. I see.
Nice supposition. But the real question is, can you back it up? Where's the evidence that proved the body was hidden in that location?
Oh, die schmeiß ich dir jetzt direkt ins Gesicht. Bitte sehr.
Mr. Armstrong, do you recognize this bottle?
No, 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 no. I have never seen that ugly bottle before in my life. I only use the very best bottles, monsieur. The highest quality only for me.
Where was that bottle found, Mr. Wright?
Interestingly enough, Your Honor, it was found in the kitchen of Trebien.
Quoi? But I only ever use these bottles for my aromatherapy oils. These bottles.
But this bottle doesn't contain aromatherapy oil, Mr. Armstrong. No, it contains a medication.
What kind of medication?
I'm sure everyone remembers, don't they, that Mr. Elk visited an otolaryngological clinic and was given medication that day. You can't be serious.
The defense had the contents of the bottle analyzed, and I have the lab results here.
The contents of the bottle matched the prescription that was given to Mr. Elk.
Len Elk's murderer hid the body in the restaurant kitchen, at which time this bottle fell out of the victim's pocket. Mr. Armstrong, when the incident occurred, didn't you say you were in the kitchen?
Mon Dieu.
Yes, you know what I'm about to say. It was you who hid the victim's body. You did a fine job pretending to defend my client, Maggie Bird. However, you were setting her up to take the fall behind the poor girl's back.
No!
Order, order! This is an extraordinary development. Witness, did you murder Mr. Glenn Elk?
Never. I could not do such an horrible thing.
Das kann nicht gesund sein.
Mr. Godot?
The bitterness. Every time I get lied to, I always down a mug of coffee. That's one of my rules.
Do you have the slightest idea how many cups you've had by now?
Then I like to do the same to the person who lied to me. I like to take them down with my empty cup. Listen up, chef. How about a brand new flavor in your ear? My age-deficient friend.
Je veux de mon pardon, please, you must hear me out. It is a trap, listen to me. Pour favor.
Yo.
Yo hablo español, Mr. Armstrong, and por favor is Spanish.
I'm only going to ask you once, did you do it?
No, 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 absolutely no, I...
Let's hear it. You've got one shot. Roy Grams.
Witness, the court will permit you the chance to make one final statement. If you lie under oath again, Mr. Godot's coffee mug awaits you.
schöne Drohung hier.
As does my gavel.
Oui, it is clear.
What do they always say in the movies? I've got a bad feeling about this.
Very well, begin your final testimony, Mr. Armstrong.
It is true. I eat la body in la kitchen. A man forced me to do it. I had no choice. I had to go along with him because there was a reason why I could not refuse. But I did not kill him. I swear it. You must believe me.
You were forced by who?
I cannot say. Or I will be erased.
Let's try a different question, then. When Mr. Elk died, was he really the only person at his table?
There was
Oh.
There was another man.
I knew it.
Maggie was telling the truth.
You may cross-examine the witness now, Mr. Wright.
There's just one more thing I need to do. I gotta break this guy and get him to tell us the name of the real killer. Gotta break this guy, klingt ein bisschen brutal.
Okay. It is true, I eat the body in the kitchen.
Did you carry the body by yourself?
Oui, I carried him, and I carried Maggie too.
Maggie too?
When she saw the victim collapse, she fainted. I could not leave her there.
But why did you hide the bodies?
A man forced me to do it. I had no choice.
What man? Who was he?
No, I cannot say. I fear for my life.
He's really scared. You just have to put the words in his mouth, Nick. Yeah, you're right. If he won't tell me, I'll tell him.
But why would you go along with this man?
I had to go along with him because there was a reason why I could not refuse.
And what reason would that be, Mr. Armstrong?
You know, monsieur.
Yes?
Surely you cannot expect a young maiden to talk about such an embarrassed wife.
A maiden? You're a bit old to get away with that word. And a bit too ma- Can't finish the cross-examination without establishing his reason. So I'll just have to prove it with evidence. Okay. He's already confessed this much. He might as well stop dancing around the real issue. Yeah, but he really doesn't want to tell us who the killer is. Then sock it to him, Nick. Yeah, that's not a bad idea. Das habe ich jetzt gerade auch so sehen, was wrong, and to go along with him. But I did not kill him, I swear, you must believe me. So, you are claiming that all you did was hide the bodies, is that correct?
Oui, that's right.
If we are to believe you, Mr. Armstrong, you must tell the court everything. You must make clear the identity of the man who ordered you to do this.
Okay, was hat man? Ich nehme an, dann muss ich jetzt einfach, a man forced me to do it. I had no choice. Also muss ich jetzt als Evidence quasi, weil er es nicht sagen will, präsentieren, wer es ist. So habe ich das jetzt verstanden. Scheint so zu funktionieren. Let's end this dance of ring around the rosy, Mr. Armstrong. This is the man that you've been referring to.
Who is that? I feel like I've seen him somewhere before.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe a month ago in this very courtroom because you were too fucking blind that he doesn't actually look like me. I mean, he looks a bit like me, but... That's all. This man is Furio Tiger. He's the manager of a loan office called Tender Lender. There's no point trying to hide the truth anymore, Mr. Armstrong. I know you couldn't go against Mr. Tiger, at least not while he had this on you. The loan contract, you know. A $500,000 loan from a black market loan shark. And you had no way of paying it back, did you? That's why you were forced to do anything this man told you.
Oui, it is as you say.
Mr. Armstrong.
Le Tiger, he told me he was going to use my restaurant for a business rendezvous. On the day in question, he was meeting the victim to demand that he repay his loan.
Okay.
I don't know why it happened like that. I just did what he told me to do. I had no choice. I carried the body and the inconscient Maggie out of the dining area and into the kitchen. After that, I just tried to forget what I had seen.
I think we can now safely say that the man who forced your hand was Mr. Furio Tiger.
I do have one further question for you, Mr. Armstrong. The poison and the lottery ticket that were found in the defendant's apron pocket. Was that your doing as well?
No, I knew nothing about that. Making it look like it was Maggie who had done it, I was not. It is despicable.
Mr. Goodall, you will summon this Furio Tiger as a witness. I doubt that can be arranged today, so we will adjourn for now. Proceedings will continue tomorrow.
Minutes.
What?
The trial will go on. I'll see to it myself. I need half an hour to get that guy on the stand. Not a minute more.
How the...
Don't sit back and relax yet, Troit. No one knows if that chef is really telling the truth or not. This trial could still go either way.
Very well. Your request is granted, Mr. Godot. We will resume once Mr. Tiger is ready to take the stand. Until then, court is adjourned for a 30-minute recess.
To be continued. Ich denke, das ist ein guter Zeitpunkt, um heute aufzuhören. Bei dem Kaffeekonsum kann ja niemals 30 Minuten durch die Gegend fahren ohne Pause. Da ist was dran. Vielleicht hat er ja auch Furio Tiger schon irgendwie 10 Minuten um die Ecke stehen. Er hat nur 20 Minuten noch oben drauf gerechnet, weil er so oft auf Toilette muss.